people who are caught up in their sin are concerned about glorifying themselves, satisfying their own personal desires or whatever, and not obeying God. Nope. Falling short, and the glory of God is not there. And so you look at the psalmist here, and he gives you a hint as to what we can do. You know, he said, blessed or happy are those who are blameless, who walk according to the law of the Lord. You're happy when you're walking in harmony with God, just like Adam and Eve did. That's why Jesus Christ came, to pay the debt. So now we are no longer enemies of God. Having been justified by faith, we have peace with God. So once again, we can walk with him. We can fellowship with him. We can please his and cause him to smile and see the radiance of his face on us in our obedience to him. Amen. And we obey him. Why? Because we have a heart for him. We'll have a heart so strong for him that we're going to be like the psalmist and say that my face just pours down tears because your law is being broken. First in your own life, and then in the lives of brothers and sisters who say with their lips they love God. Well, he gives us some ideas here, and I'll just camp on a couple of things and then we'll have to go. But it says here, it says, let's go to the second part. By the way, these are broken down, and those little titles are the alphabet of the Hebrew alphabet, is what that is. Let's take a look at Beth, or verse 10. It says, the question is, how can a young man keep his way pure? How can any of us keep our way pure? Well, it's simple. It says, by living according to your word. All right? Then he says this. This is how he's going to do it. He says, first of all, what? I seek you, O Lord, with all of my heart. And for the Hebrew, the heart is the whole ball of wax, as we used to say. It's everything. It's your intellect. It's your feelings, and it's your actions. It's everything. You want to seek him with all of your heart. That's what he does. He says, I seek you with all of my heart. He says, don't let me stray from your commands. When you seek God with all of your heart, you love him so much that you want to say, oh God. You know, I used to say, God, take away my free will. Just give me an automatic obedience to you, and this will be great. Anybody else feel that way? Because you feel so bad. You know, do it again. Of course, the enemy comes in condemnation. No, but no, honor the gentle conviction of the Holy Spirit, because he's there to restore you. Once you confess your sins, he's faithful and just to do that. But he said, look, the more you guys search him, from with all of your heart, you're going to find yourself saying, oh God, you know, just keep me from breaking your commands. And then he says, I have hidden your word in my heart that I may not sin against you. I have hidden your word in my heart. Remember the New Testament where the guy found the treasure and he looked around and he covered it up and he went and got the money he could to buy the field of treasure? You know, it's hidden deep. It's treasured. And if you treasure the word of God in your heart, it says, what? Then I will not sin against you. Paul said, what is your sword? It's the word of God. What does it mean in your heart? In your thoughts, in your feelings, and in your actions. That's why, oh, I can't memorize. Try it. Amen. Get that word deep down in your soul. So that it's down there. So the Holy Spirit, oh, how blessed we are. The Holy Spirit, our teacher's in there willing to use that word and wants to use that word to keep us strong. And we will not sin against him. So he says, hide the word in your heart and I will not sin against you. Open my eyes that I may see wonderful things in your law. How do you pray? Look at chapter or verses 33. Here's a good prayer for all of us. Verse 33, teach me, O Lord, to follow your decrees, and I will keep them to the end. Ask him for understanding. Look at 35, direct me in the paths of your commands. Why? Because there I find delight. Listen, my friend, you're not going to have any completion of your joy and your delight unless you're in Christ, closely walking in communion with him. So he's saying that. He says, turn my heart toward your statutes and not toward selfish gain. Turn my eyes from worthless things. Oh my goodness. Where do our eyes go? Where do we spend our time? Thank God you guys in the first phase can't have those stupid phones. Everybody's like this, you know? Go to PFA and the pastoral staff is checking their emails. It's ridiculous.
It is.
You know, we always say to turn our eyes from worthless things. We always think of pornography, anything that takes your heart and your mind off of God. Well, my time is up. But you know what? I challenge you to really chew on this. You know, there's so many portions of this that just, it just overflows with so much passion and zeal. And I challenge you people, you know what? If you love me, Jesus said what? You keep my commandments. And that if can be put, it can be interpreted as since. Since you love me, keep my commandments. If you really love God, you're going to want to walk in His way.
Amen.
You're going to want to walk in His way. Amen?
Amen.
Heavenly Father, I just pray in the name of Jesus, God, that we catch this, God. But we know that those who are in Christ Jesus have the Holy Spirit, the teacher. And the teacher uses the Word of God. Help us, O God, to lay aside all the extra stuff and get right down to the Word of God. Open our eyes, O God, that we might see wonderful things in your law. Oh God, I just pray earnestly, God, that the Word of God would go deep in our hearts, O God, that we would not sin against you, because the more we grow closer to you, the more we delight in you, the more joy and peace we have in you, the more you're glorified. The more you're glorified, the happier we are, and we're free. We're free. And help us to live as men and women who are free, filled with the Word of God, loving the Word of God, and walking the Word of God. Because God, we look to you. In Jesus' name,
amen. Amen.
To the maker of the mountains I can know God's working in you, doing His will and His good pleasure, isn't He? Can you just sense and feel as you read the Word of God, it's alive? One of my favorite scriptures, 119:71, it's good for me that I've been afflicted, yes, that I might learn thy statutes. Amen? Amen. If need be, we were talking about the other day, you can look that up in 1 Peter 1:6, and if need be, we need some struggles and problems. Let's just let God be God. Amen?
Amen?
Because He knows what He's doing. He knows how to fix what's wrong, get us fired up, primed up, and ready to go. And then when He sends us out, He says, you go, I'm going to go with you. That means the Holy Spirit's guiding. Amen?
Amen?
That's exciting. You know, it's had a really hard time this week. Because Danny messed up. Danny Flossie. Nothing really, you know, really sinful, bad. He just, a little anger got a hold of him inside. And he overreacted. And so I was just praying. So we've taken him out of leadership position as associate pastor, at least for the first year. Now he's still a pastor, but he's not, he doesn't have the authority he once had. And he's struggling with it, but he's willing to be afflicted so I can learn my statutes. Amen?
Amen.
How many really want God to be God, no matter what?
Amen.
I'm done. Well, you can keep your hand down if you want. If you can raise it up, but you know what I mean, you can do that too. Let me tell you something. I love God. You're going to know them by their fruit.
Amen.
Talks cheap, whiskey, cost money. Man, you can rant and rave and hoot, holler, shout, moan, groan, grab, all of it. You put on the front lines. We'll find out what you're made of.
Amen.
Then you turn tail and run. You're going to know. Is that right, Zoe? Get down there with those old Crips and Bloods. You get down that old Indian reservation. Well, I mean to tell you, we'll go out there in the streets and start preaching, and your enemy's fighting you. You wake up one morning and think, man, I haven't been tempted like this. I ain't even saved. That's just the enemy lying to you. Amen? Because he knows what God's fixing to do. So, you know what? I gotta quit. God uses Satan. You know that? God uses Satan to perfect the saints. That's us. Now, can you imagine God uses Satan to make us stronger so we can defeat him? You get to reading that. You get to praying. You get to seeking. You're going to find that out. And by the way, if you use a little sleep because you're praying, you poor thing. Man, look at you. Look at you used to do for your sin. Amen? We got God. Amen? Working our lives. Pastor Ken, would you pray us out?